Hey. Can we meet up today?
Yo, two girls by my side, I can handle them. Romantic scenes like the candles then. It was August when I seen her, but it was nothing deep, just an entanglement. Yo, she kept playing with me, but the brain was silly, gave Jay the willy. No back, but the face is pretty. If I ever fall in love, you can blame the kitty. Look, I got a million flows, but none of them's millions flow. Ask Joe, man's really involved in a nigger in stole. That's bigger than toes, round air, man's king and it shows. Round air, man's really the most, that's about him in a T and that nigger's unknown. Gonna give it this bone, all you hear is wait, wait, wait when I dig a girl slow. I don't want love, I just want fuck. But what is it, just an entanglement? Sold you a dream by accident. Girl catch feelings when I hang
now
with
I'm
them.
In a hotel with a fresh candle, cause she want her hair pulled and her neck strangled. Cut her head getting mangled and dangled to the side. Now it's got her brother entangled for real.
I don't want love, I just want fuck. But what is it, just an entanglement? Sold you a dream by accident. Girl catch feelings when I hang
now
with
I'm
them.
In a hotel with a fresh candle, cause she want her hair pulled and her neck strangled. Cut her head getting mangled and dangled to the side. Now it's got her brother entangled for real.
Well, somebody's hungry today.
Girl, I'm sorry, but this here is some bomb-ass salad. How come you ain't take me here before? Look, girl, I'm sorry, but it's getting repetitive now. Don't you want to be happy? Relationships are toxic, and they just make you miserable. Look at me. I'm divorced and having the time of my life, and you need to follow suit and leave and start living life again, girl. Or do you want to continue on for another 5 years, trying to make your 10-year engagement work?
But I love him. I can't leave. Doesn't even feel real. The lonely nights, him not being around. And even when he is around, he doesn't even notice me. It's like I'm invisible. But I know we can fix it. It just takes some time.
Look, Simone, as your best friend, I'll always support you. But it doesn't mean I support this situation you're in. Why don't you try roleplay? You could wear a new wig, dress different, create a totally new personality. Just make it a whole new experience for him, you know? Something new.
But I want him to want me, not somebody else.
It's not even like that. It's just something to spice things up.
I guess we could try it.
Damien used to love it. One thing we actually did well together.
You still miss him, don't you?
Hell no. In fact, I've got a dick appointment tonight.
With who?
A guy called Tyrone. What?
Not no damn Tyrone.
What?
You better call Tyrone.
Girl, bye. I hate you. Why you gotta ruin everything?
Hey, babe.
Hey, I didn't think you were gonna pick up. I called you a couple times already.
I'm sorry. You know I've been busy. I left you a note this morning. At a meeting.
Yeah, I know. Another business meeting on a Sunday.
And what are you trying to get at?
Nothing. Anyways, I wanted to ask if you were gonna come home early tomorrow after work.
Yeah, I should be. I don't have anything scheduled. Why?
I just thought I would cook up something nice.
Yeah, sounds good. I'll make sure I'm there. Babe, I need to go. I'll speak to you later.
Sure, okay. I love you. What I need you to do is send somebody ASAP.
I'm sorry, but all our mechanics are busy.
Busy? What the hell am I paying you for? What do you expect me to do?
Look, this lady, is some bull. You're gonna have to calm down. Like I said before, I can get someone out to you in 2 hours.
2 hours is too long. You've got to find a way. This is an emergency.
You need any help?
How about no?
Just trying to help.
I'm sorry, but I can't do anything about it.
Look, I need this car fixed right now. I'm downtown and there's some weird people here. And quite frankly, I don't feel safe. You need to bring somebody here now. Hello? Hello? I know this bitch didn't just hang up on me. Are you kidding me? What am I supposed to do now? So, you know about cars? This is gonna take long, because I got somewhere to be.
Don't worry. I'll be done soon. Seems like you're having a bit of a bad day.
Well, duh. My car just broke down.
You gotta chill. It could be a lot worse. You live around here?
No, just visiting.
That's a shame. I'm new in town and I was hoping to find someone who could show me around. It's a big city and it get lonely out here, you know what I'm saying?
No, I don't. But I hope you find that someone.
All right, it's all done. Go check and see if it's running now. It was a blown fuse. It should be okay for now.
Hey. Thank you. How much do I owe you?
You ain't gotta worry about it. I just hope that you find something good come out of today. I hate to see a beautiful lady upset. Take care of yourself.
Well, look who finally decided to make it home.
Don't be starting nothing, Simone.
Don't start? You know exactly what you did, Ryan.
I really don't have time, Simone. You know I'm working. Why you always gotta be interrupting me?
Oh, we're gonna talk about this. You gave me your word that you were gonna come back home early from work when I asked you. And what did you do? You left me here all night waiting for your ass. You're a special kind of fool, huh?
Oh,
what? You forgot? Like you always do. You just can't help yourself, can you?
I forgot. I'm sorry. It's just work has been getting real stressful lately. So much is going on that I just keep forgetting about all these things. I wish you could see that. It's not like I'm trying to hurt you on purpose, baby.
There you go, using that excuse again. Work, work, work. When will you ever decide to put me first? I'm your fiancé, Ryan.
And as your fiancé, all I'm trying to do is provide for you, for us.
Oh, here we go. You always gotta play the money card.
Now, how about you listen to me?
Whatever.
This place we live in? The food that you always buying, the clothes on your back, all me. Me. My work paid for that. Oh, and that Gucci bag that you love so much? Yeah. Me. My work paid for that.
Oh, what, you want a reward? I would pay you back with some ass, but you're never here for me to even give it to you.
You know what? I don't got time
for this. Yeah, you go back to work because that's what you always do. Forget about me. I'm not important enough. One day, I'm gonna leave your trifling ass, and then you'll realize. Oh, I can't stand you sometimes. Stupid ass. I don't even know why I bother.
Do you mind? You gonna get that?
Hi?
How did you know where I live? Did you follow me here?
Wait, this is your crib? I thought you said you wasn't even from this city.
Simone, who is that? Silas?
Hey, Ryan.
What?
I thought I got the wrong address.
I can't believe it, man.
I know, man. It's been years. Wow, you got a real nice place here, man. You're doing real good.
Yeah, well, that's all thanks to my hard work. Some people don't understand that. It takes a lot of work to acquire these things.
Yeah, you're right about that.
So you ain't even told me what you're doing here, man.
I just got a new job here. At an auto body repair shop. I had to leave home. Start. Afresh. I just thought it would be best for me.
Oh, is this because of what happened to Keisha?
Yeah. Everything just reminded me of her. Thanks. Appreciate it.
Yeah, I heard about it. I'm sorry you had to go through that. We all thought that you two we'll be together forever.
Yeah, I thought so too.
So, how do you two know each other?
We met at college.
College?
Yeah, Silas was my main man back then. We were close. We did everything together. Mainly chasing all them girls on campus.
Yeah, right?
Yeah. You know what I'm talking about. Like, you know, hey, you know how I get down, man. All right, man. Oh, sorry. Yeah, Silas is also the smartest guy you'll ever meet. He had a scholarship and everything.
Yeah, till I gave that all up.
Yeah, that was real sad, bro.
Why? What happened?
I had to drop out of college. My girl Keisha got pregnant, and I had to help provide.
Oh, so you got kids?
No, we lost the baby. What's even worse is that she only just told me that the baby wasn't even mine. It was Miles's.
Are you serious?
Yeah, but you know what? I don't really want to keep talking about it. It just makes me turn into someone that I don't want to be. And that's why I've come here, for a fresh start.
Yeah, I get it, bro. Do what you need to, man.
Yeah, anyway, on another note, how about you? Are y'all together or what?
Oh, yeah. Sorry. This is my fiancé, Simone.
Fiancé? Congrats, man. When are you getting married?
We're still trying to set a date.
We've been trying to set a date for 5 years now.
You've been engaged for 5 years?
You know these things take time. I just want to make sure that we're both mentally and financially stable before we get married. Is it a crime?
Nah, I hear you.
But anyway, I want to hear more about you. Where are you even staying at?
Well, it's a motel on the other side of town. It's called Hotel Jolly.
Hotel Jolly?
What's wrong?
That place got hella roaches. Not to mention the fact that they find a dead body there almost every week.
Yeah, but there's not much I can do. That's all I can afford right now.
Nah. No friend of mine is staying at no raggedy-ass motel. Why don't you come stay here with us? We got a spare empty room. You ain't got to pay nothing. Just stay till you get back on your feet.
Nah, I wouldn't want to intrude.
Nah. You ain't got to worry about that. I'm perfectly fine with it.
Are you okay with it, Simone?
Yeah, sure, you can stay.
Well, then it's settled. Babe, get us another couple of beers. Let's celebrate. Yo, I'm so excited, man. It'd just be like old times. Hey, yo, babe, make sure that beer is cold. I don't like none of that warm shit.
Niggas is mad, I get more buck than ashtrays. Fuck the fair one, I get mine the fast way. Ski mask way, nigga ransom notes. Far from handsome, but damn a nigga tote much. More guns than roses. Roses shaking in their boots. Invisible bully, like the gooch. Disappear, vamoose, you lie to me. Take them rhymes back to the factory. I see the gimmicks, the whack lyrics.
Everything's locked up. Better safe than sorry.
Simone, come on, we're gonna be late.
I forgot my Gucci bag.
Damn, we're gonna miss all the good stuff. Wait, who is that? Oh, God.
Hi, again.
Oh, Silas. I wasn't expecting you to be here so soon.
Yeah, I like to get things done ahead of time. Just makes life a lot easier, you know?
Is that all you're bringing with you?
Yeah, I meant what I said about starting afresh. I didn't bring much with me when I moved here.
So you've got the key, right?
Yeah. I went by Ryan's office earlier and picked him up.
I'm surprised you even got to see him. He's always held up in some meeting.
Nah. You're right. I ended up getting him from his assistant.
Right. Well, you can go up and unpack. There's some food in the refrigerator left for you.
Thank you. Look, I really appreciate you guys for doing this for me, especially you. You don't even know me, but allowed me to stay at your place. And for that, I'm grateful. Thank you again.
It's not a problem. I have to go now. My friend Lisa is waiting for me, and I know she's just about ready to beat my ass.
Oh, shit.
Okay. Well, I'll see you later then.
Yeah. What?
Who was that, Simone?
One of Ryan's old friends. He just moved into town and he'll be staying with us until he gets his own place.
Oh, he is fine. You might need to invite me over for a slumber party soon because I need to get me some of that.
Oh, here we go.
Hook your girl up.
Bye, Lisa.
Oh, come on, Simone.
We're already late.
Come on! Power tap that ass! Tap that ass! 1, 2, 3, 4, I step the poop, better wipe it off. 1, 2, 3, 4, I step the poop, better wipe it off. Ride the horse! Keep fucking y'all! Come on, slide! Click, clickety clack! Slide! Click, clickety clack! Just slide! Click, clickety clack! Here come the cops! River dance! Come on, white people! River dance! Come on, white people! River dance! Come on! Now pop me up! Pop it down! And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Why do we keep going to that man's class?
Because it's hilarious.
And cheap. He's such a creep. His breath stinks. Oh, my God.
You know, underneath all of that, I believe he's a very handsome man with a very big...
Please don't.
Heart. Girl, please. Did you not see the print in those shorts? Busta is pack-a-lackin'.
Okay, we're gonna have to move on from this because you're clearly doing too much now.
But you know I ain't lying.
You're too old to be acting like this, Lisa. Nobody was looking at that man's package, trust me.
I'm divorced and lonely. Can you blame me? I mean, if a certain person would just hook me up with a certain guy that's currently staying with them, then maybe I wouldn't be so thirsty.
I don't even know the guy. He could be a psycho, a thief, a killer. I literally had to lock up all my stuff at the apartment in case he tried to steal anything.
Seriously? Why do you always assume the worst in people?
I just don't know him. And I'm not comfortable with him staying with us.
So, why did you allow him to stay with you then?
Because he's Ryan's friend. And I just don't need more problems between us.
Well, apart from being exceptionally fine, he does seem like a good guy. Don't be so quick to judge.
Yeah, you're right.
So, will he be invited to your birthday festivities?
What birthday festivities?
It's your birthday in a couple of days, and we're going out to celebrate.
No, we ain't going anywhere. I'm gonna be with Ryan.
The same Ryan that's never there?
You seem to be forgetting that Ryan always came through for me on my birthday. You remember when he threw me that surprise party 2 years ago? Or the time he flew me to Paris? Even with all this going on, there's no way he would miss out on my birthday. I guarantee it.
What? You a fool. See, that's why I don't trust these niggas. They think they slick, but let me tell you, sis, can't nobody fool me.
See, Marco tried to do me like that just the other day, talking about he's busy working late.
Nigga, please, working late my ass. This guy don't even like to work. How you gonna agree to work extra hours?
So of course I decided to pop up at his job, and guess what I see? I see this nigga and some bitch slumped over the ice cream machine, fucking like two dogs. So you know what I had to do? I had to beat both their asses and make sure I left with a Big Mac and some fries.
Simone.
Girl, you gotta be real stupid to believe that kind of bull. No wonder why their ice cream machine always stay broken.
I'm really sorry about our new receptionist over there. She's my husband's cousin, and I was forced into giving her a job. Big mistake.
I know the feeling. Working with family members, worst experience ever. Just don't end up almost getting arrested like I did.
I'm trying not to, trust me. So, what is my beautiful client looking to get done today then?
Well, it's my birthday tomorrow, and I just figured that I would try something different.
Aw, happy birthday in advance, girl. So what are you planning on doing?
Well, I'm not sure yet, but I know my fiancé has something special planned for us. And I want to make sure I look good for the occasion. And maybe try a completely new look.
Aw, that is so sweet. You've got a good man. My husband always seems to forget mine. The last time he forgot, I ended up guilt-tripping him into buying me this salon. Bet he won't forget again this year. But I'm sure your man is different. Hell, he probably been acting up recently because he's trying to throw you off the scent. I'm sure he's out right now planning the most amazing birthday for you.
Yeah, boy. You know you can't get this ball off me. Just like in college, I was always the better player, both in and off the court.
Yeah, you always had a lot of talk, but no game. Let me see you do something, bruh.
Oh, I see. You must have got amnesia somewhere down the line because you acting like you don't know about my skills. Let me jog your memory real quick. Those flashbacks starting to kick in, huh?
Yeah, you're probably right.
Well, let's go make some magic. We're gonna make sure you look extra fine for this occasion.
You're supposed to be engaged, bruh.
Hey, I'm allowed to look, ain't I? As long as there's nothing physical involved, then it ain't nothing wrong with it, my brother.
Well, whilst we're on the topic, let's be real. What's the real reason you haven't married Simone yet? I mean, you said you wanted to wait till you were both all set. But, bruh, you a whole successful architect. You make a lot of money, and you live in a nice place. What are you waiting for?
It's not that simple, man. It's just life. Me and Simone just, well, I haven't been getting along for a while now. I can't see myself getting married with all this tension between us. It wouldn't be right. Same goes for my job. I've been busy lately. Real busy. And I sure ain't got time to be planning a wedding. It's just better left as is for the time being.
You should really tell Simone how you feel.
Man, it's nothing to discuss. Even a blind man can see that our relationship is fucked up at this point.
But I don't think she sees it that way. Look, you can see that she really wants to marry you. And you prolonging this is only making things worse. You ever wonder why you got all this tension? You don't need to plan no big fancy wedding. Just make her your wife.
Simone is the most bougiest woman I know. She's not going for that.
Have you ever thought to ask her? If you gave her the choice between choosing to wait a couple more years or getting married right now in a courthouse wedding, what would she say? I bet I know the answer. Be careful. Simone is a good woman, and I wouldn't want to see you lose her to someone else.
You better slide him back home. Don't want to miss that game. Get up out of here.
Girl, I'm so shook right now. This has got to be my best creation yet. Why don't you turn around and see just how amazing you look? So, what do you think?
Wow. I love it.
Damn, you just gonna let him run through you like that? What are you all defending? A damn wall? Bro, what are you doing? I'm not even capping him.
Hey, yo. I'm gonna go get some snacks.
Come on, man. Y'all killing me over here. Hey, yo, grab me another beer, too. Damn. I should have been in the NFL.
Hey, Silas. Are you okay?
Your hair. It looks different. Wow. You look amazing.
Oh, thank you. I didn't think anyone would notice.
Well, I did. And you look great.
Thank you.
Yo, you really trying to mess with my head? Because this can't be real.
Ryan?
See? That's why you don't pass the ball at the 1 yard line.
Ryan?
Huh? Wait, hold up, babe. I'm watching again. And it's getting real good right now. Hey, Moss, what you doing, man? I don't think he stepped out either. That may be the greatest catch I've ever seen.
I'll be in my room. You have to be kidding me. That is impossible.
Best catch ever. What? Anybody could have caught that shit. Hey, thanks, man.
Why did you have to ignore her like that, bruh?
What are you talking about?
She wanted your attention and you just shut her down. You didn't even get to see her.
She what? I see her damn near every day.
She switched her hair up. Maybe she wanted to surprise you.
Ah, that. It's probably just another one of her wigs. She left one sitting on the dining table the other day. Like, what? If I find some of that hair on my food, bro? Just reckless.
What? Where am I? What is this place? How did I get here? A beautiful bouquet of flowers for an even more beautiful woman. I want to show you just how much I appreciate you. Meet me outside. Ryan.
Stars or the end of a rainbow, but I found my pot of gold in love. It seems like a dream, this love ever flowing. It's definitely you that the birds sing of. There's never a time when I can feel you here. I know we're always together. Oh. And if having you is simply loving you, I guess I'll have you forever.
Happy birthday, baby.
But what is this, Ryan? Where are we? And how did I end up here?
We're in Cancun, and well, I may have put a questionable amount of NyQuil in your coffee yesterday.
You drugged me? Are you being serious right now?
Hey.
You could have
killed me. Let's not ruin this right now. Look, Simone. I know I may do a lot of stupid things at times, and for that, I apologize. But my main and biggest apology to you is that I'm sorry I haven't treated you as well as I should have. Simone, you are the most greatest thing that has ever happened to me, and I want you to know just how much I love and appreciate you.
Oh, Ryan.
I brought you here today to celebrate your special day. As well as to also celebrate our new life as husband and wife. Will you do me the honor of marrying me today?
Ryan, I don't want you to feel like you have to do this for me. I need you to want this as much as I do, and I just don't want you to regret this.
I can never regret this. I'm sorry if I ever made it seem like that's how I felt, because it's not. Ever since I laid eyes on you, I knew that I was gonna make you my wife. Now, somewhere down the line, I let life get a hold of my true intention. But I'm not gonna allow it to get between us again. I love you, Simone. And I don't know what I would do without you. Marrying you would make me the happiest man on this earth.
Okay.
Yeah.
Of course I will marry you.
Hey, yo, my man. Let's get started. I got a beautiful woman to marry.
I can't. can't hear anything he's saying.
He's got an accent. You ain't gotta be rude.
No, his mouth is moving, but nothing is coming out. Am I the only one noticing this?
I can hear perfectly fine, so don't stop acting up.
What is happening? And what is that beeping noise?
What the hell is in that NyQuil? Simone! 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 Simone!
Of course it was a dream. Ryan? Not even a damn card.
The Bimbalapa wicks are soon. Double your block, your blocks of Memphis.
Forgot my birthday and forgot your keys. Shame. The fuck? You've got a lot of nerve.
Happy birthday, bestie! I know you're an old lady now, but that don't stop you from still throwing some ass. Damn, what happened to you?
Lisa, what exactly are you doing here?
To celebrate and get lit. Plus, I brought some goodies.
Alizé.
What's wrong with Alizé?
I told you I was spending the day with Ryan, and we're in the middle of something right now. So you need to leave.
Oh, really?
Yes, really.
Excuse you?
Hey, you're not supposed to be here.
Ryan! Oh, Ryan! Where art thou? Oh, there you are. I'm sorry for interrupting this special moment you guys have got going on here. Silly me, always overstepping my boundaries. Wait, are y'all doing fancy dress? Well, let me guess. You came as Casper the Friendly Ghost. Now let's cut the crap. Ryan is not here. He still got you a gift, right? Oh. Ooh, child, I need to put these bottles down. When are you going to realize that this man does not give a damn about you? Why do you keep making excuses for him? A man that doesn't care to be around you? Doesn't care to pay you any attention? Barely even talks to you. Is this what you call love? This is not something that you keep trying to fix. This is something that you have to free yourself from. starting now. We're gonna try to salvage what's left of this night. It's your birthday and you need to have fun. Now you need to walk your ass into that room of yours and go find something cute to wear. And fix that hair too. Cute color, by the way, but fix it.
I can't.
Now let's get into this alizé.
I'm gonna keep it real. Oh, it's something about you. I'm gonna break it down. They don't know your style. I'm gonna keep it real.
I don't want your number, sir.
Will you give me chill?
Better there than here. This isn't my kind of scene, okay?
Quit being so uppity and let your goddamn guard down for once in your life. Ugh! Now you bumping into me. Well, hey. You kind of fine. What's your name?
If you in the car right now, I need you to roll those windows down. If you in the house, turn the windows up. Turn the windows up, turn your computers up. You know what it is?
And you strong.
Lisa.
I bet you got some big feet too.
Lisa. Whatever.
You so crazy.
You cute and all, but I don't mix business with pleasure. Well, you look like you need a drink. What can I get you? Whiskey on the rocks. Coming right up. Here. Thank you. Another one. You might want to slow down on this one. And you might want to start minding the business that pays you. Don't you have other people to tend to? Barmaid. You know what? I don't want to have to beat your ass tonight. So I'm gonna go ahead and leave you to it, bitch. Now I need a damn drink.
I think you just blew your chances of getting another drink tonight.
Silas, what are you doing here?
I was just about to ask you the same question. I didn't take you for the clubbing type.
Well, that's because I'm not. I do bars and lounges, not clubs. I was dragged here by my crazy friend, but of course she's too preoccupied with the company of men. As per usual.
Aw, yeah!
Oh, the infamous Lisa. You guys seem worlds apart. How did you both end up becoming friends?
Yeah, you're right. We are worlds apart. But she's always been a good friend to me, despite our differences. She's always been there. She was my sore at college, and back then I find it quite hard to make friends. Everyone thought I was a snobby-ass bitch and wanted nothing to do with me. But she gave me a chance. She knew I wasn't like that. Or at least didn't mean to be. I guess it's kind of like you and Ryan. You both seem so different. How does someone like you end up being friends with a person like him?
Well, it's kind of funny because we didn't get along at first. He was this popular pretty boy on campus. Talked so much smack, couldn't stand it. You see, I'm from the hood. We don't take to Nick. I mean, guys like that. But one night after work, I was heading back to my dorm. His car pulled up next to me.
Yo, Silas!
I heard someone call my name, and by the time I turned around to look,
R.I.P., nigga!
I was on the ground. The car sped off, and I was just lying there. At that point, I knew I wasn't gonna make it. Nobody was around to help me. But then, I saw this light. I thought God was telling me to come home. As if God would want someone like me up there.
Shit.
Oh, but nah, man. It wasn't God. It was Ryan.
Oh, shit. Yo, somebody help. Yo, somebody help. Stay with me, man. Stay with me.
I don't know how, but he found me. After that, come on. I blacked out. I woke up the next morning in the hospital. I probably would have never made it if it wasn't for him.
Wow. I'm sorry that happened to you. Did you ever find out who did it?
Let's just say I dealt with a lot of bad people back then. And they wasn't too happy about me leaving and trying to make a better life for myself.
So you knew who they were. I hope you had them put behind bars.
Nah, I ain't no snitch. But I've always believed that in life, you get what you give. And last I heard, every one of them was 6 feet under. Karma never loses an address. But yeah, after that, me and Ryan became real close. He's a good guy deep down.
Yeah, sure he is.
You know, it's getting real hard for me to ignore the conflict between you two. I don't mean to pry, but what's the issue?
The issue is when you pour all your love into someone and you receive nothing back. The issue is when you're constantly being ignored by that person to the point to where you just feel invisible. The issue is when you haven't been intimate with a person in 6 whole months. The issue is when you've been together for 7 damn years and he can't even remember it's your birthday today.
Wait a minute. It's your birthday today? Damn. Happy birthday. I'm sorry. I didn't know.
How would you have known? I didn't tell you. But thanks.
I didn't realize it was this bad. I honestly thought it was just about you getting married. But I see it's a lot more to it. I'm sorry that you've had to go through this. You don't deserve it. But why is it that you haven't just decided to leave?
Because I love him too much. And I don't know why, because he treats me so bad that it hurts. But he wasn't always like this. He used to be the most kindest, romantic man. The kind that you would fall in love with in an instant. But somewhere down the line, things changed. He's not the man I once knew.
Look, I know you probably might not want to hear this from me, but I don't think you should continue to stay in a relationship that you're unhappy in. Sometimes you gotta think, what's love gotta do with it? Is it worth compromising your happiness for? Your state of mind and your dignity? You need to forget what you feel and remember what it is that you deserve.
Now this is for all my grown and sexy folk in the building. Ladies, hold on to your man. And fellas, grab on to your girl. Cause there's about to be some sweet loving in the atmosphere tonight.
I can't believe they're playing this song. It was always a favorite of mine. As a kid, I used to watch my parents dance together to this song. I could see the love in their eyes. What they had was real. I always dreamt of having a relationship just like theirs. I wanted to feel what my mother felt. I wanted that same love. The fire, the passion. Oh, you're leaving?
How about you come dance with me? At least, let this be my birthday gift to you tonight.
I don't know. My love is sweet, baby. sorry, this was a mistake. I have to go.
I got a business trip I need to attend, so I won't be here for a couple of days. See you later, then.
What did I do to offend you? What did I do? Because I don't understand why I'm being treated like this.
Damn! Are we really going through this again? It's a business trip!
Going through this again? Is that all you can say? Is that where we're at now? We can't even communicate like adults anymore. And this isn't about your stupid, poxy little business trip. This is about me. This is about everything I've had to endure with you. You know, it was my birthday yesterday. Or did that slip your mind too? I really tried, Ryan. God knows I have. Any other woman would have left, but silly me, I choose to stay. Even when everybody told me not to. But I'm just a fool in love. Clearly, that love is all just make-believe.
I don't have time for this.
Run off, Ryan. Run off from the truth, because you know you're guilty of all the shit you've put me through. The truth always hurts.
You know what? Why don't I just put you out of your misery? Maybe we should take a break.
A break? What do you think this is? An episode of Friends? I want you to talk to me. I want you to understand your wrongdoings. I want you to change.
Or maybe I can't. I'm leaving.
You know what? Fuck you, Ryan. Good fucking riddance. I wish I'd never met your little sorry good-for-nothing ass.
Tell me who has it been?
Simone? Simone. I heard about what happened between you and Ryan. I know you probably don't want to speak to me, especially after last night. But at least allow me to be of some support to you during this time. I know how it feels. Trust me, I've been there before. I may not be a therapist, but I'm here to listen to you and be that shoulder to cry on. Simone, please speak to me. Just let me know if there's anything I can do to help.
Maybe there is something you can do.
What are you doing, Simone? This is not what you want.
Well, I beg to differ.
Thank you.
Lisa?
Girl, why are you calling me in the middle of the night?
It's 11 o'clock in the morning, actually.
And?
I did the unthinkable.
Huh.
I cheated on Ryan.
What?
I know. I don't know what came over me. It just happened so fast. Now I don't know what to do.
You don't know what to do? Girl, you need to be popping open a bottle of champagne and rejoicing.
What?
Girl, you ain't had any in over a year, and you out here being mad at yourself? For what?
It's been 6 months, actually, but that still doesn't give me a reason to cheat on my fiancé.
Girl, bye. Forget about that. This is exactly what you need and rightly deserve. Are you honestly telling me that you don't feel both exhilarated and empowered? The sex was good, right? Wait, did y'all even have sex or did you just kiss a guy and call it cheating?
We had sex.
Ooh, was it nasty?
Okay, look, I didn't call you for this. I just need to know what to do. I feel so guilty.
Baby girl, you need to stop all this guilt nonsense and do a Stella and get your damn groove back. Use this as an opportunity to bring back all of what has been robbed from you for all these years. Don't you miss being the old you?
The single, sexy, independent.
Hello?
Girl, I'm gonna have to call you back.
What?
Just think about what I said. This just may be what you need, friend.
But I just... Hello?
Well, it seems like you're ready for another round, mister.
Beaumont and his wife Keisha Bailey's perfect union seems to be in turmoil. Now, we all know that Miles has always been a Lothario, but his acting skills with Keisha have been quite impressive. So, reports have been made that Miles is expecting his fifth child. And this is not with Keisha. The lady in question is Instagram model Natalia Valderez, and she is currently 6 months pregnant. Now, if you remember correctly, didn't we all watch Miles and Keisha's big extravagant wedding live just 6 months ago? I sure do. Tut, tut, tut. A leopard truly cannot change their spots. So, here's the interesting part. Miles denies all allegations, and of course, Keisha continues to stand by her man. But Natalia posted on Instagram just 2 days ago that Keisha tried to pay her to keep the pregnancy a secret. She also claimed that she practically cried and begged her to keep quiet as she didn't want to face any public humiliation. Now, honey, don't you think it's just a little bit too late for that? Let me give you some advice, Keisha. Just take what you can and run along, girl. Or, well, you know, you could just make do and cry in that "I'm sorry I cheated" Bentley that he just bought you.
Hey. Why did you switch off the TV? Do you not like Wilma?
Nothing wrong with Wilma. I just don't really feel like hearing about my ex-wife and the guy she cheated on me with.
What? Keisha Bailey is your wife, Keisha? Are you kidding me?
Was my ex-wife.
Wait, so Miles, the guy she left you for, is the Miles Beaumont, the basketball player? Why have you never mentioned this before?
Because it doesn't mean anything.
Well, it does when it involves such a famous and high-profile person like Miles Beaumont.
Oh, so it wouldn't be as important if he were just some regular old Joe like me, huh?
Oh, come on now, Silas. You know that's not what I meant. But you've never really spoken much about it. And I can tell that you still haven't gotten over her. Tell me, what happened? Why do you hold so much pain?
She was the love of my life. It's not that easy to just forget. I gave up everything for her. Only to have it all thrown back up in my face, like what I did and how I felt meant nothing at all. When I first met her, I said right there and then that I was gonna make her my wife. And when I found out she was pregnant, it just confirmed everything for me. Probably wasn't the best timing for either of us, but I knew I had to step up and be responsible. So I dropped out of college. We got married and I got myself a job fixing cars. I was lucky because the dude that owned the place took a liking to me. And when he sadly passed on, he gave me the shop to run. It was just what I needed, you know? With a baby on the way, I finally felt secure. The months rolled by and the shop was making a lot of money, so I was able to get us a little apartment downtown. Did up the nursery real nice, and then came the big day. She spent 18 hours in labor. 18 whole hours. And from that came our perfect little baby boy. I fell in love instantly. I'd never seen anything more beautiful. We hadn't thought much about names. But when I saw him, he looked just like an angel. So I called him just that, Angel. But Keisha suddenly, for some reason, was so hell-bent on calling him MJ. Said it was because of her dad. Cause his name was Maximilian or some shit like that. And well, my dumbass believed it. Why would I think anything different? MJ. Miles fucking Jr. Not that it even mattered anyways. He got taken away from us soon after. He died of pneumonia. That was the worst day of my life. Keisha didn't hold up too well. I think she became suicidal. But there was no way I was gonna lose her too. I had to do something. Keisha was really good at hair. Back at college, she used to do everybody's hair. Used to braid mine too. I remember just how good it used to make her feel. So I thought maybe this is what she needed. She stayed at home a lot. So I thought it would be best for her to be in a different space. I sold the shop and used the money to buy a new spot for her to use as a hair salon. I cared more about her happiness than anything else. Well, it worked. She started smiling more, laughing more, and going out more. Yeah, she went out a lot. She started getting some celeb clientele, and she just started getting invited to all these events. She was networking. I think that's when she met Miles again. Probably the first time she'd seen him since he left college to play pro. It must have brought back a lot of those hidden feelings she had for him. I don't know. But they must have been seeing each other for a good while before she decided to up and leave me. She couldn't even tell me to my face. Just ended up leaving me a stupid letter. I don't think she ever really loved me.
She didn't deserve you. People would throw away a diamond. Only for them to pick up a rock. I dug for so many years and all I could find were rocks and stones. But I think I may have found a diamond. The same one Keisha threw away.
Ryan to fix that months ago. Oh my god.
Damn, I was really enjoying that. I didn't know you had all those moves.
Well, there's a lot you don't know about me.
Oh, really?
You are looking at West Park Squad Best Female Hip Hop Dancer of 95 to 99.
Oh, it's like that?
Always. Even Caramel Sundays is getting touch. Scoop in my ice cream truck. Who tears it up?
Hmm. Something smells good.
Well, I decided to make some lunch for you to take to work. I don't think it's good for you to keep wasting your money at that stupid diner you always seem to go to.
Oh, you mean the one with the girls that serve you peaches and cream pancakes and booty shorts?
It's giving very much tacky.
Do I detect a hint of jealousy? You see, I've only got eyes for one woman, and she's standing right in front of me. Beautiful, intelligent, reigning dance champion. You do something to me, Simone. No words can fully describe the feelings I have for you. And for that, I'm not looking to go anywhere.
The king is back!
Hey, Ryan. What's good?
What's up, man? What's going on, baby?
Yo, you looking good, man. What they got you doing in them business trips?
Hey, my man, that's what you call money. That's what happens when you're making boss moves. Have you out here looking like Bill Gates and shit, man. You know what time it is. Probably smell like him, too. Ugh. Hey, Simone. Silas, do you mind giving us a minute, please?
Yeah, I was gonna head off to work anyway. Thanks again for the food. I'll see you later on.
Damn! What you packing over there? A 3-course meal?
You got jokes. Anyway, I'm gonna catch you later, man.
Yeah, be safe, bro. So, you not gonna look at me? Look, Simone. I'm sorry for the way I left things between us the other day. These past couple of days made me realize just how wrong I've been. I honestly never meant to hurt you or make you feel unwanted. I love you. Simone, please look at me. Baby!
Don't you dare baby me. You don't know what the meaning of love is.
You are practically glowing. Let me guess. You got a new Chanel moisturizer?
More like a big bottle of Ebony Bronze Mansterizer.
Wait a minute. You're not still messing with that guy.
Why do you sound so surprised? It was your advice that I decided to take after all.
You have never listened to anything I've had to say, Simone. Don't try and put this on me. Hell, I thought you would have ran straight to a church confessional, asking God for his almighty forgiveness. I can't believe you did it. Well, damn. He must have a ding-a-ling of gold because he's got you out here looking real different. I mean, you were in short shorts during the middle of fall. It really is hot girl summer all year round for you, huh?
And what exactly is wrong with that?
It's just not you. Well, I guess I'll never know who this mystery boo thing of yours is.
It's Silas.
Ah! Bà điên
rồi. Oh God. I'm so sorry, Kim.
Quá quắt lắm rồi.
Được ba cái đồng bạc. Tip you an extra $3 so you can buy your new shirt.
Silas? You slept with Silas?
And I've been enjoying every minute of it.
What happened to... I don't trust him. I don't know him. He could be a criminal. Did all of that just suddenly fly out the window once he dropped his pants?
Well, kinda.
Girl, you slept with your fiancé's best friend.
Say it a little louder, why don't you? I don't think the whole shop quite heard you. And they're not best friends. They're just close.
Woo chow. This tea is hot. But I'm not even gonna sit here and pretend to be mad at you, girl. Even though... I'm a little pissed that you got to him before I did. But I'm just glad to see you happy.
Thanks. And I am. He's just so kind and attentive. He listens. He notices every bit of me. I never realized just how much I was deprived of being with Ryan. It was like Silas and I were in this wild, surreal bubble, and out of nowhere, Ryan comes in and pops it. For a while, I actually forgot that he existed. It was all going so well, or so I thought.
And so what if he's back? Maybe this is the excuse that you need to finally leave his ass. There is no way I would want to go back to a toxic relationship after experiencing something so sensational. And with the way you were just talking about Silas, you're definitely smitten, girl. You better tell Ryan to go kick rocks.
You're right.
Oh, honey, you know I'm always right. This is just the first time that you're choosing to acknowledge it. I can't believe I missed out on all this tea, honey. You were just gonna keep this all for me.
I most definitely tried to call you. And I even went to your apartment a couple times. But you were nowhere to be found.
Oh, I went on a vacation.
Let me guess. With Tyrone?
No, Dante. Tyrone was starting to get on my nerves. He had a terrible foot fetish.
I'm sorry, but I just can't do this with you anymore. I've had some time to really think about us, and I've come to the realization that this relationship ended a long time ago. When someone truly cares for you, they make an effort, not an excuse. And I'm tired of hearing those excuses. It's time that I finally make a decision that's best for me, the right decision. At least now I'm wise enough to say that this is not what I want. I'm leaving you, Ryan.
You must got the wrong person, baby. Because ain't nobody ever decided to leave me. The fuck you think this is?
You can do this. Just leave his ass and never look back. Is Silas trying to get us caught? It's Ryan's handwriting. Why do I have this sudden feeling of deja vu?
I know it's hard for you to want to speak or even listen to me right now, but I'm begging you to please give me a chance to explain. I want you to meet me here at this location tonight. I also got you something to wear. I saw that you had circulated out in that fashion magazine you always read. See, I noticed that. Now, I don't want you to assume that I'm just trying to buy your forgiveness, because I'm not. I just want us to fix this. And I know I've been the villain all this while, so it's only right for me to repair this mess that I've caused. Allow me the chance to make it right. I'll be waiting here for you.